हेलो गाइस, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। सो एज इन द प्रीवियस लेसन आई रिवाइज अबाउट द नेक्रोसिस, सो हेयर इन दिस टूडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज द टॉपिक अपोप्टोसिस। सो बेसिकली अपोप्टोसिस मीन्स द प्रोग्राम्ड सेल डेथ एंड अपोप्टोसिस इज अ कैस्पेज डिपेंडेंट प्रोग्राम्ड सेल डेथ। सो हेयर वी मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट अपोप्टोसिस इज अ कैस्पेज डिपेंडेंट प्रोग्राम्ड सेल डेथ and it is not associated with inflammation, as we studied in necrosis part that necrosis is associated with inflammation, and in Greek word apoptosis means falling off, means something fall off. So falling off, apoptosis in Greek word means falling off, and apoptosis, A for apoptosis, A for active process. So apoptosis is an active process, means it in this uses ATP. So ATP is utilized in this process, so it is an active process. And in the necrosis, as we study that it was the passive process, no use of ATP in necrosis. And necrosis is a pathological process, and apoptosis is a physiological as well as pathological process. It means that apoptosis can occur physiologically also, and it can also occur pathologically. So in physiological apoptosis, examples were like embryogenesis and organogenesis, during the formation of the embryo and during the formation of the organs, like during the interdigitate process. So there is apoptosis of the interdigitate fingers, and as well as pathological process. So example of pathological processes were viral hepatitis. In viral hepatitis, councilman bodies is a body of the apoptotic bodies, and other example is chemotherapy induced cancer cell death. In chemotherapy induced cancer cell death, it is both apoptosis and necrosis, but here apoptosis path is more in this chemotherapy induced cancer cell death. So as I told you that apoptosis is a caspase dependent programmed cell death. So here C4, for this there is one trick, like C4 cysteine residue, ASP means break after the aspartic acid residue, and AS means enzyme. So cysteine residue, break after the aspartic acid and enzyme. So here like it breaks after every aspartic acid. So caspase is in this there were initiator and executors. In initiators we have two pathway, extrinsic pathway and intrinsic pathway, and executors. So in initiators we have 8, 9, and 10. Executors were 3, 6, and 7. So in initiator we have extrinsic pathway and intrinsic pathway. Intrinsic pathway occurs in the mitochondria, and extrinsic pathway is also known as death receptor pathway. Extrinsic pathway is also known as death receptor pathway. Intrinsic pathway is also known as mitochondrial pathway. And initiator we have 8, 9 and 10, and 8 is absent in the human apoptosis, and in executors we have 3, 6, 7, and the most important is 3. So now let's do one by one by extrinsic pathway. So extrinsic pathway, other name is the death receptor pathway. So E means 8 and X means 10. In Roman number we write 10 like X. So here 8 and 10. And as we know that in the initiators we have 8, 9 and 10. So 8 and 10 were used in the extrinsic pathway, that is death receptor pathway. So suppose this is the T cell, and here is the apoptotic cell. So on the apoptotic cell there is CD95 and FAS receptors were present, and on the T cell CD95 ligand and FAS ligand were present. So during the apoptosis there is trimerization occurs, and in trimerization FADD, FAS associated death domain. So in extrinsic pathway there is trimerization, in trimerization FADD, FAS associated death domain. So in this trimerization will activate the procaspase 8 10 into the caspase 8 and 10, and if they are activated by FADD, it means that they are also inhibited. So who will inhibit? It is inhibited by FLIP. So FLIP will inhibit this pathway, procaspase 8 10 to caspase 8 and 10. So this is the extrinsic pathway, that other name is death receptor pathway. Now we are going to learn about the intrinsic pathway, and it is the part of the initiator. So in intrinsic pathway, S from the intrinsic, IN, as we reverse it, it means NI, means 9, NINE, 9. So in this 9 initiator is present, so in it is occurs in the mitochondrial pathway because it is inside, so it the intrinsic pathway. So during the stress, as stress sensor activated, and stress sensor activated will like BIM, BID, BAD, NOXA and PUMA. BIM, BID, BAD, NOXA and PUMA. So they basically they balance between the pro apoptotic factor and anti apoptotic factors. So as the stress sensors get activated, so there is disbalance between the pro apoptotic and anti apoptotic factors. So basically in this, after the stress sensor activated, they increase the apoptosis process and decrease the anti-apoptotic factors. So in anti-apoptotic factors, there is one word like we have to remember L. So like BCL2, MCL1 and BCLXL. So in anti-apoptotic factor, L will come in every number like BCL2, MCL1, BCLXL. Except the BCLX5, which is the pro-apoptotic factors. And in this sex, steroids were also the anti-apoptotic factors, and glucocorticoid is the pro-apoptotic factors. So after this, there is disbalance between the apoptosis and anti-apoptotic factors, which were caused by the stress activating factors. Stress sensor activated. Now after in the mitochondria, we have cytochrome C, which will combine with the apoptosis activating factor 1, means cytochrome C plus APEF1, and they will form the apoptosome. They will form apoptosome. Apoptosome is a wheel-like hexamer which activate the procaspase 9 into the caspase 9, and it is the intrinsic pathway. So here the inhibitor is IAP. IAP inhibit this pathway, procaspase 9 into caspase 9. And in mitochondria, there is MEK and Diablo, which will inhibit the inhibitor of anti-apoptotic factors. So this is all about the intrinsic pathway of the initiator. Now the executor pathway. In the executor pathway, the 8 and 9, 10, these were activated in the initiator pathway. So they activate the executors like 367, and 367 get activated. They phospholipase, protease and endonuclease. Here endonuclease is the reason of causing the stepladder pattern in the apoptosis. So basically endonuclease jo hai, it break at every 180 to 200 base pairs, also known as internucleosomal cleavage. This is the reason for stepladder pattern. So now in the cell, as they were cell in the apoptotic bodies, they were cell membrane bound organelles with or without the nucleus, and which were recognized by the macrophages. So basically, as we see, there is the apoptotic bodies, and phospholipid bilayer is present. So phosphatidyl serine movement from inside to the outside. So this phosphatidyl serine movement is recognized by the annexin 5 factors. Annexin 5 factors recognize the phosphatidyl serine movements. And this phosphatidyl serine movement from inside to outside gives the eat me signal, and flipping will occur, which signal to the macrophages, and phagocytosis will occur. This is the executioner pathway in which 3, 6 and 7 were involved. So now the detection of the apoptosis markers were annexin 5. So it marks the movement of phosphatidyl serine. Molecular markers were CD95 and FAS, and microscopic examinations, the hallmark of the apoptosis is nuclear chromatin condensation is the hallmark of the apoptosis. Now tunnel stain positive and tunnel stain negative, P4 positive, P4 apoptosis. So your tunnel stain positive in apoptosis and tunnel stain negative in necrosis. Now next, the gel electrophoresis, as I already told, in apoptosis stepladder pattern is seen by the endonuclease. So a stepladder pattern is seen in the apoptosis. This is the stepladder pattern. And in necrosis, there is smearing pattern, and this is the necrosis pattern. Now, नेक्स्ट वर्ड डेथ इज नेक्रोप्टोसिस. नेक्रोप्टोसिस मीन्स नेक्रोसिस प्लस अपोप्टोसिस. सो इन दिस बोथ वर प्रोसेस वर अकर नेक्रोसिस प्लस अपोप्टोसिस. सो इन नेक्रोसिस फ्रॉम द नेक्रोसिस इन्फ्लेमेशन इज प्रेजेंट एंड फ्रॉम द बट हेयर द इट इज द कैसपेज इंडिपेंडेंट पाथवे. एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट अपोप्टोसिस इज अ कैसपेज डिपेंडेंट पाथवे बट हेयर नेक्रोप्टोसिस इज कैसपेज इंडिपेंडेंट पाथवे. सो apoptosis, as I already told you, it is both physiological and pathological process. Here also in necroptosis, physiological plus pathological. Physiological process like growth plate formation and pathological like steatohepatitis and pancreatitis. So mechanism of necroptosis is like tumor necrotic factor and tumor necrotic factor receptors. They activate the RIP1, RIP3 and procaspase 8 and procaspase 8 will cause the cell death. Next is the pyroptosis. In pyroptosis, we have microorganisms. Pyro means pus formation. So basically in this bacterial involvement, so Salmonella and Shigella, pyroptosis. So bacteria will enter into the cells and bacteria gets activate the node-like receptors and node-like receptors activate the inflammasomes and inflammasomes activate the caspase 1 and caspase 11. Caspase 1 will activate the interleukin 1 and interleukin 1, as we all know that it is the interleukin for the fever. So fever will occur. And interleukin 1 also activates the cell death. In this process, in this way, cell death will occur in the pyroptosis. Now next is the anoikis. Anoikis, A means anoikis, A for apoptosis. So basically it is the type of the apoptosis. So anoikis is the type of the apoptosis, and in this, cell death is due to the loss of natural environment. So these were the notes. I hope you all enjoy it. Thank you.